Today, we're gonna get all our USB cables out, turn our cameras on, and I'm gonna go over all the different ways that you can connect your Fujifilm camera to your PC or your Mac. Yeah, school's back in session. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. For today's video, I will be covering the Fujifilm X-T2, X-T3, and X-T4 cameras. However, much of what I'm talking about will apply to most other Fujifilm cameras as well. The first thing you'll need is the right USB cable. For the X-T2, you will need a Type B micro USB cable. For the X-T3 or X-T4, you'll need a Type C USB cable. I'll have links to these cables in the description down below in case you don't know which one to get for your specific camera. Now that you've got your cable and your camera, it's time to go into the settings menu and pick a connection mode. Go into the wrench, into where it says connection setting, go down to connection mode, and you will see five options there. There are five different connection modes, each of them performing specific functions on your camera. There's USB card reader, USB tether shooting auto, USB tether shooting fixed, wireless tether shooting fixed, and USB raw convert backup restore. If you happen to see that wireless tether shooting fixed is grayed out, this is because you do not yet have a connection set up. We'll go over that in a minute. The first connection type is USB card reader. The USB card reader connection option allows you to connect your camera to your computer, and your computer will recognize your SD card that's in the camera. Then you can open, move, rename, and whatever to your photos on your camera's SD card, but using your computer. Simply connect your camera, and you'll see it appear right here in your menu. And you can browse the SD card on the camera just like you would with any hard drive on your computer. The next connection type is USB tether shooting auto. This mode actually does three separate things. First, it allows you to shoot images that will show up immediately in software such as Capture One or Lightroom. So for example, I have Capture One open right now and I'm gonna turn the camera on in USB tether shooting auto. And as you can see, my camera settings and everything else appear right here. Aim the camera and take a shot. And it appears right in the software from the camera. Very cool. I can even start the live view right now and have my camera in a live mode. So what happened was I was plugging in the USB cable and the tethering wasn't working. I was getting this error message right here and it was driving me nuts. I was ready to throw the computer out the window. So the reason I was getting that error message was because the USB cable that I had connected to my camera, I was plugging it into here, this hub. And then this hub is plugged right into the back of my Mac Mini, okay? The problem with that is it doesn't work. What you have to do is you have to plug your USB cable directly into your computer. Don't put it into a hub if you get that error message. The second thing that USB tether shooting auto can do is allow your Fujifilm camera to be controlled by a gimbal. I will connect my Fujifilm camera to this gimbal. I will turn the camera on, connect it to the gimbal. So now that the Fujifilm camera is connected to the gimbal via USB tether shooting auto, I can control the camera using the controls right on the gimbal. I can start and stop recording. I'm focusing using the focus ring on the DJI Ronin. Lastly, USB tether shooting auto is also used by Fujifilm X webcam software that allows your Fujifilm camera to act like a webcam. I have a whole video on how to set this up, so be sure to check that out if you're interested in using your Fujifilm camera as a webcam. The next connection mode is USB tether shooting fixed. This one's a little weird. First off, it's almost identical to the one we've just discussed, you know, USB tether shooting auto. However, there are two main differences. First, when you take a photo in this mode, it does not save the photo to the SD card. It only saves it to the computer or the device that you're tethering to. The second thing is that the camera will remain in tethered mode even if the device is disconnected. The reason for this is that this will better allow the device to quickly resume control when connection is reestablished with the camera. So basically, when the connection comes back up, you can continue shooting. What you need to understand about these tethered modes is that once you set your camera to them and then you connect your camera to the computer, your computer will take control of the camera. In other words, your camera will no longer function in the normal way during the time that you're tethering. Because of this, you don't want to leave your camera in the tethering connection mode once you're finished tethering. Go ahead and put your camera back to USB card reader mode so that your camera will act and function normally. Number four on the list is wireless tether shooting fixed. This mode is exactly the same as USB tether shooting fixed, except that it does it wirelessly without the USB cable. It also doesn't save your image to the SD card on the camera, but only wirelessly to the computer. Yeah, nothing bad could ever happen with that setup, right? Let me save you some time right now. Don't bother with this one. First of all, the wireless connection setup and reliability of this can be a little goofy. Secondly, when you go and you take a photo, the speed at which the photo travels from the camera to the computer can take forever. I mean, forever. By the time your raw files get from the camera to your computer, you can be collecting your pension. And I can't think of a single reason to use this mode. However, at least you know what it is. To set it up, you go into your little wrench in the menu setting under connection setting, down to connection mode, and you will see that it is grayed out. Do you see that right there? So go to network setting, also in the little wrench, wireless access point setting, and I'll do manual setup, select from network list. Choose your Wi-Fi network, put in your Wi-Fi password, and hit set. And you're waiting. And you're still waiting. Waiting, waiting, waiting. The hell with this thing. Okay, I'm not gonna demo this. This is so frustrating, which is whole my point. Don't use the wireless Wi-Fi. It just get yourself a USB cable, okay? It's so much easier. It's still connecting. It's still trying to connect. I literally have the router right here. It still can't connect. Look, look, look at this. The router is right there. And the last connection that we have is USB raw convert backup restore. This connection mode actually allows you to do two separate things. The first is that you can save and then restore your camera settings. I have a whole video on exactly how to do that I'll put a link, you know where the links are. The second thing you can do with this connection mode is actually kind of cool. If you download the free Fujifilm X RAW Studio software, you can then use this connection mode, connect your camera to the computer, and then process RAW files that are on your computer, but using the RAW processor on the camera, which is really, when you get right down to it, the best RAW processor there is. I'm gonna go ahead and put connection mode into USB RAW convert backup restore. Once again, I'm gonna connect the camera to the computer. Okay, so I have a RAW file that I shot several months ago, and it's on my desktop here on my computer. What I'm going to do is flip over to my desktop using this file browser. It's asking me where the source image is. There it is right here. And it's loading it into Fujifilm X RAW Studio. Now what I can do is convert it. Suppose I want to put it into classic Chrome. Or let's say I want to put it in monochrome. Whatever film simulation, there it is. And I can change all of these other parameters as well, the shadow tone, the clarity, and so forth, and simply hit convert. And it did the conversion perfectly. Have a look at that. There's my original RAW file. There's the conversion. So with this free software and using this connection mode, you can convert all of your Fujifilm RAW files into JPEGs using the film sims and all of the other settings that are available to you in the camera. It's wonderful. One last thing I do want to tell you about this. It's sort of a tip. If you are connecting your Fujifilm camera using the tethered connection or any kind of connection as far as I'm concerned, and you're transferring photos back and forth or sending photos from your camera to your computer, well, I strongly recommend that you go into the menu, into the wrench where it says Power Management, and make sure that auto power off is set to off. You do not want the camera auto powering off in the middle of a tethered shoot or a transfer of an image because you may lose the image. Well, I hope this video has been helpful to you. If it has, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I am currently working on Capture One lesson number 5. So if you've not yet watched lessons 1 through 4, be sure to check those out before you see lesson 5. But you've got a few weeks. I still have to get caught up on product reviews and other videos. But in the meantime, thank you for watching, and I'll see you very soon. Take care.